Welcome to Postscript. Here we hope to answer your questions and help you dig deeper into the messages and sermons at Faithbridge by talking with the teacher of the day.
Hi, welcome to another edition of Postscript. I'm Dan Slagle, care and bridging pastor here at Faithbridge, and today I am with Luann Riley, who brought us a terrific message on the prophet Jonah, kicking off a three-part series on Jonah. Job well done.
Thank you.
Yeah. One question came in, which I think is a fairly common question regarding not only Jonah, but many of the stories in the Old Testament. And to give the questioner his due, I'm going to read the whole thing.
Okay,
it's a little lengthy.
Yeah.
In school, I learned how the Jews used parables and stories to illustrate their God, similar to Jesus. While Jonah was a real prophet, is this story a parable or considered factual? There is truth in it for sure, but I think stories like this have been defended as factual, thus turning people away from the Bible, seeing it as myths.
Yeah. Well, I relate to the questioner because in my period of running from the church, I feel like I questioned everything about the Bible and everything about faith, and I could argue against all of it. And so when I was preparing for Jonah and just really diving into his story and reading about it, that is one of the debates among scholars and commentators. I land in that Jonah is truth because it's in the Bible, but I find that there's a couple of indicators to me that sort of land me in that camp.
Okay.
And I believe the first one is that Jesus actually references Jonah's story when he's here and he's teaching, and he's teaching to the disciples and the Pharisees, and he says to them, the sign of Jonah, and he's referencing Jonah's story. He's talking about Jonah being in the well for 3 days. Then we see Jesus being in the tomb for 3 days. I believe that that is pointing to the truth that we find in Jonah's story, and that it would have been a story that was familiar to those who were listening. But I think the second thing, and it's the reason that I believe I came around the corner when I stopped running and I finally turned back to God and everything changed for me. If I have a God who can raise someone from the dead, I mean, we saw it happen, Jesus do it, and then God raises Jesus. If he can raise Jesus from the dead, then I would believe that keeping Jonah alive for 3 days in a fish would not be beyond what my God can do.
Yeah.
And I think that if you approach the Bible without a relationship with Jesus or without the proper view of God, then those things do seem like they could be fairy tales, or that they don't. How could you ever believe this? But when you have the right view of God and you understand just his presence and his bigness, and that there's nothing, like he created the earth by just speaking it out, that there's nothing impossible for him. And so when you approach the Bible from a standpoint of this faith in a Jesus who died for us and who was risen from the dead, then I believe those stories fall more in line with who God is.
Yeah, much like the debate over the existence of God, miracles such as this cannot be proved, but neither can they be disproved by the canons of logic or the scientific method, either one. And so I think to a large extent, probably exclusively, it depends on your worldview. If your worldview disallows the possibility of the miraculous, then this is going to be a parable. On the other hand, if your worldview permits the existence of a God who is over his creation and intervenes through the miraculous, then yeah, I would say this is probably pretty simple for God to do. Yeah, good. Well, great message to get
us
going. Next week, we pick up with the fish story. And I'm sure it'll continue to be a great series for all of us.
Thank you, Dan.
Thanks a lot. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you next time on Postscript.
Thanks for joining us for Postscript. Help us keep the podcast interactive by submitting your questions during the morning services. Learn more at faithbridge.org/postscript.